put that, a fraction into division, we say top and bottom, okay? So those we're pretty familiar with. Multiplication is where it sort of gets hot, okay? The reason why, like, we started with this is our OG elementary school, and yes, that's my comfort zone. But as you've heard, the rumors are true, we will start to throw letters into math, and X is a letter. And so they said, okay, we've got to come up with some different ways. We can't just use X as a multiplication sign. So they have these other ways to do it, okay? So there's like a little dot bullet point. It's, you know, the bullet point that's used as multiplication, the asterisk on the keyboard, okay? And then these two. On this one right here, AB, it will never be two numbers written like that. You will never see like three times four like that, because what does that actually look like? Three, four, yeah. If they ever don't use like one of these three signs, they will say three times four. Okay, so that would be three times four, it's the same as three in parentheses four, which is the same as three bullet point four. They won't do it with numbers like that, and then three. Okay, those are just some different signs and symbols. If you look at today's notes, you'll see it there too. They're like from. So that's the first thing. We are going to model and solve. Some of these models will be a little weird, but let's just go with it. Okay, something to remember is that when I have a negative sign, sometimes I'm going to use, what did we say yesterday? Sometimes we think the opposite. Y'all remember that? We're going to use that opposite for the negative signs again today. It's going to be helpful. The models are, you're going to have to sit there and like go, huh? It's going to be fine. So on this first one, with multiplication, in elementary school, we always learned it was like three groups of four, right? Okay, we're going to have six groups of negative three. Okay, this means six groups of negative three. So y'all write this down. Six groups of negative three. To model that, I'm going to draw six groups of negative three. So I'm going to do one, two, three. 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 Six groups, negative three. So in total, turn off my counter, I'm going to have 18, negative 18. My answer is negative 18. It's not too bad. Okay. It'll get a little spicier. Okay? On number lines, instead of doing groups, we're going to do hops. We're going to do six hops of negative three. Where do we always start on the number line?
Even.
Zero. Okay, so I'm going to start at zero. My first hop is going to land at negative three. Then it's going to be at negative six. And keep going. Hops of three. Should land you on negative 18. Okay, hopefully you're writing this along with me. On the next one, negative nine groups of two. That's a little weird to say, right? But we learned in elementary school, like, I can switch it and it's still okay, right? Can I do two groups of negative nine?
Yes.
Sure, let's do that. Okay, let's do two groups of negative nine. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Question? If it's a positive and negative like that, we just said we would sort of switch it around. Okay? It's okay, because you're noticing things. Okay? So, when I have those two groups of negative nine, in total I have negative 18 again. Okay? So I'm going to do two hops of how much? Of negative nine. So again, I'm going to start at zero. My first hop is going to land me at negative nine. My second hop lands me at
negative
18. Okay, one, two hops of negative nine, negative 18. Those are pretty good. When I can switch it around like that, it's not too bad. This next one's a little weird because I can't switch around. I have negative four groups of negative four. Okay, so this is when I use my friend the opposite. Okay, I'm going to make this first one, this first negative sign, be the opposite. I'm going to say the words, I want to model the opposite not 16, it's negative 16. But if I do the opposite of it, that's going to be 16, like positive 16. Okay, maybe write the opposite so you don't forget. The opposite. Again, this opposite thing is going to look, it's going to look weird on the number line. Just accept it, just go with it. Okay? I'm going to do the four hops of negative 4. Four hops of negative 4. So that's negative 4, negative 8, negative 12, negative 16. But I need to remember at the very end to flip it. Switch it, flip it, the opposite of it. Okay? The opposite. Exclamation. It's important. Okay? With division, okay, division is sort of a weird one too. Division, we're getting our total. The first number is always our total amount, so 5, negative 14, negative 8. That's what we're starting with. And then the second number is like how many groups we're splitting it into or how many is in each group, where it's going to get a little weird. Because if I look at the first one, I'm starting with 5 and dividing it into groups of negative 5. Do I have any negatives? No, so that's weird. So that's when I make that negative. What word instead?
Positive.
Opposite. Okay? I'm going to make it the opposite of 5 divided into groups of 5. Into groups of 5. The opposite of 5 divided into groups of 5. Just bear with me, you'll see. Okay? So that top 5, the what's it, the dividend? Okay? Is that a positive or a negative 5?
Positive.
It's a positive 5. So I'm going to start with positive 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm going to circle each group of 5 that I can make. How many groups of 5 can I make?
One.
I make one group of 5. But what can I not forget? The opposite. Okay? So it's going to be negative 1 because there was one group. There was one.
So it's the opposite of the group.
Yes. Correct.
Oh, I thought it was the opposite of
what's going on. No. I want to know how many groups of 5 I'm able to make. I'm able to make one group. But because it's the opposite of one group, it's going to be negative 1 group. Okay. I know it's weird to think about, but just go, you're like, no, I'm sort of uncomfortable, I sort of just face it. No, so let's do another one. So, if I do that next one, it would be negative 14 divided into groups of 7. But do I have any positives to do groups of 7? No, so I'm going to take that negative out, and I'm going to do the opposite, okay? So I'm going to do, yeah, it's sort of going to be flipped. The opposite. Of 14 divided into groups of 7. That's a lot of words. Divided into groups of 7. Huh? I'm taking the negative out. Okay, instead I'm doing the opposite.
So whenever you talk, you just take the negative out?
Yeah, you sort of just, you don't always, so the last one we won't have to, but you always think it through. Okay? So, let's do 14 divided into groups of 7. So, because I took the opposite, I'm making that 14 a positive for right now. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Bear with me. Y'all are doing good. Y'all are being flexible. I appreciate it. How many groups of 7 can I make there?
Two.
I can make 2 groups of 7. But I need to remember to do the opposite. So instead of 2, it's going to be
negative
2. Oh, Miss Wildness is giving her number one. Let's go back to those in a second. We'll finish it up, and then we'll go back and do the last one. Okay, so this last one, I'm starting with negative 8, dividing into groups of negative 2. Can I do that?
Yes.
So do I need to take out the opposite? No. Okay? So I'm going to just write negative 8 divided into groups of negative division, what kind of rules we see, okay, in a second.
So with division, it's most likely, would help keep on negative.
So.
Oh, because there's a lot of negative dollars too.
Yes, we're seeing those factors. Let's go back into our number line order with division, I'm just gonna be honest, okay? So, just look at how I do it, cause remember on a test, usually it's gonna be given to you in like a, like it's gonna give you the model, okay? You have to choose which one matches it or something like that, you're not gonna be sitting there drawing one on the chart, right? So, just go with it, you're gonna be like, yes ma'am. So, I'm doing, five divided to groups of five. So when I do that, I'm gonna do a hop to positive five, and then I circle the amount of groups of five. How many groups of five were there in five? There's one, so you just like say there's one here, and then you say the opposite. You'll see it better on the next one. Okay, so let's look at the next one, it'll make a little bit more sense. I'm dividing 14 into groups of seven, so I'm gonna do one big hop to 14. And then I'm gonna divide that into its groups of seven. So the first group is here, second group is there. Huh? Well, it looks weird, okay? There's two groups, but we have to remember the opposite. You know, I've never seen division number lines tested on the chart ever in my life, cause it's weird. Okay, the last one, I'm going to negatives. I'm gonna go to negative eight.
Nope.
And then I'm gonna do groups of negative two. So here's the group, here's the group, here's the group, here's the group. I was able to make four groups.
Is it the opposite?
No, cause we're dividing into groups of negative two. Let's look, okay, so some people are, you're like, ooh, I wanna figure out what's the pattern, what are the rules, what's going on. Okay, when I look at that, was the actual multiplying or dividing, like the actual number, any difference? Six and three, will that usually get me 18?
Yes.
Yes, it's just the sign that's different, right? Sometimes the sign is positive and negative, we gotta figure out that. Same thing with division, five divided by five, is that one normally? Is 5 divided by 5 1?
Yes.
Yes, it's just the sign. 14 and 7 will give me 2, it's just the sign. So what patterns are we noticing with signs? Turn and talk to the people around you, see what you can figure out. What are you noticing? Again, we're talking about what rule can we figure out if it's going to end up being a negative answer or a positive answer. What was some of the stuff you were saying? Okay, I agree. Do you agree or disagree?
Agree.
Okay, Jonathan?
Well, I kind of disagree, but I'm more...
Okay, what do you disagree about?
If it's an odd number of negatives, it would be negative. If it's a positive number...
An even number.
Positive.
So we'll get to some of those in a second. Yes. Jason?
I agree with Liz. Dividing, here, multiplying a positive by a negative.
Okay, yeah, and now we're at the point where we're repeating each other, which is awesome, because I love hearing the same things, just differently. So, a rule, a little cute little something, a little jingle that someone taught me, and I have stolen since then, is if signs are the same, positive is the game, signs are different, negative wins it. Okay, see if you agree. If signs are the same, if they're both negative, if signs are the same, positive, my answer is the game. If signs are different, if I have a positive and a negative, if signs are different, negative wins it. A different teacher. Riley.
But negative 14 and 7
Negative 14 and 7? problems on the back because I just want you to practice. I'm not making you models. There's like two model problems on the back. I want you to work out the habits. So let's look at those, flip over the page, and go ahead and solve those six problems. I'm going to give you a few minutes, okay? At home, pause, and then play when you're ready to set. Christina, number one, what did you get? Negative 60 is correct. Number two, Ryan.
Negative 27
is correct. So this is where what Jonathan was talking about. Okay, so he said if there's an odd number of negatives, it's going to be negative. If it's an even amount, so like 2, hold up, left that. If there was like 2, if it was -4 and -3, if there's 2 negatives, it's going to be a positive.
How come it's not negative 8?
So let's look at that. So y'all remember with the addition and subtraction when I did like multiples, I would chunk it, I would do 2 at a time.
Yeah.
Do the same thing here. So -3 and -3, those two, the signs are the same, so positive is going to be my gain. Bring down that -3. Okay, I use 2, I have a third one left. And those two signs are different, so negative is going to win it. 9 times 3 is 20.
Oh, I did that.
So that times that, those signs are the same. Positive is the game. That's going to be +3 times -4. Signs are different. Negative wins. Okay, when it gets too much, chunk it down. The next one. Let's see, Andrew. -8 because signs are different, so negative wins it. Jason. -6. What operation is a fraction?
Dividing.
Okay, and Natalia, the last one? +6. Very good. Okay, so it's the same multiplication division. We don't have to change anything. It's just figuring out the sign. Ryan, yes, sir.
I don't know where I did it.
What did you do?
I just took out all the negatives and I put them back in when I solved the equation.
Sure, yeah. As long as you can keep track of how many there are. Yeah. It's just normal. Riley, yes. Lucy, what's up?
Can we do the
so, let's just look at those two word columns. Y'all do them on your own, see what you can figure out. Again, pause and play when you're ready. Go. So, on the first one, it doesn't really ask the question, but you're going to be figuring out if he worked right for 5 hours. So, we did what operation with that? Lucy, go for it.
Multiplication
of 650 times 5. So, that ends up getting... So you could either say burns 3,250, but if I just wrote an integer to represent that, would it be a positive or a negative?
Negative.
It'd be a negative.
So either one would
come in. Yeah. If it asked how many he burns, you would just put 3, because it says burns, you would put 3,000, but if it said
integer represent.
Okay. Coastline received. This one was a couple of steps. So if the coastline recedes that many centimeters in 9 years, it wants to know how many meters it would do in 1 year. So it took a couple steps. So what did y'all do first? Jason, what did you do first?
450 by 9.
Well, I think it's that's how many it did in 9 years, but we're looking for 1 year. We need to break it down. So we would need to not multiply, but